Before we get into the video, in the last 30 days, around 80% of my viewers are not subscribed that have watched my content. So if you do enjoy this kind of content and want to see more, consider subscribing with notifications. I'd very much appreciate it. Without further ado, let's get on with the video. So we're going to be going ahead and upgrading my harvester hoe in Minecraft Skyblock today. We have a ton of enchant books and a decent amount of XP on our hotbar that we're going to be applying to this harvester hoe. And we're also going to be getting the nether wart mastery done on at least the level 1. So then we can build a sugarcane farm in today's video. So to start off, we're going to go ahead and start enchanting. And then I'm going to do the farming for the nether wart. And then we'll go ahead and build a sugarcane farm. So let's start out with the first plan of action, which is the enchants. So we need to go ahead and grab out these books, and we're gonna simply just go ahead and go to spawn. Actually, we can go to warp enchanter, and we'll go up to the enchanter and we'll start right clicking the Tim the enchanter and start getting some books that I might need. Currently right now we don't need book hunter. We do need speed, so we'll go ahead and just max out speed instantly, get it done and over with, even though it's not really like super reliable. There's XP finder we need. We need that one desperately, so we're gonna apply that. There we go, it applied. Nothing good here except for fortune, what I'm honestly just gonna grab even though I don't need it. Another speed, we'll grab that. I think speed goes up to 5, so we'll apply it. There we go, we're done with speed. We just need a treasure hunter. There we go, so we'll go ahead, apply the treasure hunter. Now we need to check our enchants and see which ones we need. So let's look in the harvesting hoe area. Quite literally we have everything besides spawner finder, value ticket finder, and crop crushers. Honestly, I'm just gonna trash fortune. I don't need it. It's not that great if I'm gonna be honest. We'll go ahead and apply our first crop crusher that we had previously, and it applied. But we are going to go ahead and do slash toggles and disable the enchant proc for crop crusher, of course, because I don't need to be using it as of right now. So we'll disable it. And then we just need to keep looking for crop crusher, value ticket finder, and of course spawner finder, what is going to take a lot of books opening. Never mind, we already got a value ticket finder and we have two of these, so we'll go ahead and just apply these. We got one to apply, we got the second to apply. Perfect. So we're just going through all the books, getting all crop crusher, value ticket finder, maybe means PayPal if I do have the option, because I can sell it for money, and spawner finder. What won't take too long to get all of them that we need. TV15 is going to be where I store all the books that I don't want and that I'm never going to use unless I need them for a different kind of skill tool. So like maybe a sword or something. So for now, we're just going to go ahead and put them in PV15. I'm going to go on AH and search EXP or XP, see how much it is for 100 levels. So it's about 100 million right now. Oh my gosh, the price has gone up quite a bit. There's some for 20 million actually, but honestly I'm just gonna go ahead and get those because I'm going to be needing it, and I get all my money pretty easily. Keep looking for the easy XP deals for 100 levels for around 25 million at highest. So now we should have 200 levels. Oh my gosh, I did sell a ton of value tickets off camera, and it turned out to be a good choice because honestly we're just gonna spend all that money into XP. Okay, last one that we can buy is right here. So now we have all the XP we can get. We have 251 levels. So if we need to apply anything, we'll just go ahead and apply it because we have the XP. As you can see, we got crop crusher. We're gonna go ahead, apply that, and it's 100% guaranteed. Oh wow, that's the first time I've seen that. Another crop crusher, there we go. If this applies, we're already at 3. Okay, so we're at 3. We need 2 more for that, and we still have 52 books to go. And then we have a few rebirth books. We have around 4 that I'm going to be opening, and we'll save those for the end of this little book opening session. Spawner finder, our first one. There we go. Let's go ahead and try and apply that. 86%, and it applied. Thank gosh. When you get those blue rarity ones, you want to hope they apply. So like value ticket finder and spawner finder, they're very, very important. Another spawner finder. Let's go ahead and try and apply that as well. Please work. There we go. We got 2 spawner finder, 2 value ticket finder. So in total, we need about 8 books to successfully apply. If they all apply, of course, then we only need 8, but I'm expecting one to fail at some point here. Let's just hope that does not happen. 40 books left. And of course we could get rebirth on these enchants, but we'll get rebirth eventually down the road on some of them, but it will take some time to get that since rebirth books are harder to come by. To be fair, how much is meads? So about 10 million is the lowest you can see for a meads book, but honestly I'm just gonna go ahead and sell this one for about H, sell and we're gonna do money 25, 123, 123, and that should be proper if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it is. It is the proper typing. So if I get meats, I'll just put it up for 25 million each. I'll sell eventually down the road, so it's fine. A crop crusher, perfect. Please apply properly. 90%, it applied. Perfect. We need one more of those. It would be nice to get at least crop crusher maxed out since we're pretty close to it. And we got a crop crusher. Perfect. That was like instantly. Okay, this better apply. 96%, and it applied. So now we just need value ticket finder and spawner finder. And if we get crop crusher, we'll eventually grab those and just sell them to other players, I think, because they're harder to come by. Not super hard, but they're still hard to come by. So I'll make sure to put those in PV10. We got another crop crusher. Oh my gosh. So I'm just gonna go ahead and search crop, and we'll see how much it's worth. We'll try and do 5 million, I think, just because 7 million is how much they are up there for. So 5 million per one is not bad. We also have 25 books left, so we could hopefully get another one of these kind of books that we need, or we might not. Who knows? Oh, spawner finder. There we go. Please apply. 92%. It applied. So we need 5 more books. If we actually get the 5 books and get them to all apply, that'd be amazing. Oh my gosh, we got a value ticket finder. Apply, please. Oh my gosh. Okay, we got that to apply as well. How have I not failed a single book? That's what I'm questioning. And we're about to fill a full PV of just spare books too, but I could sell. What I might sell the books down the line if I don't need them, or just keep them for spare purposes. I'm gonna sell another crop crusher we just got. I know I should be putting spawner finder and probably value ticket finder on a sword, but I don't have much into that skill, so it's honestly not worth it for me at least. Okay, we got crop crusher, value ticket finder. We're just gonna get value ticket finder. Go ahead, apply it. 82%. We didn't even fail a single book yet. That is honestly crazy. Okay, we're gonna look for more XP, see if there's any up there. 18 million, another 18 million, another 18 million. Oh my gosh, these are some easy deals. Oh, there's a ton up here. As long as it's under 25 million, I'll be buying 100 levels. So now we can go ahead, open up the rebirth books. So warp enchanter. I'd like to get at least some XP finder or book hunter. I don't really know what I want, honestly. Okay, we got book hunter, XP finder, and treasure hunter. We'll get the XP finder because I already have one, and we could just go ahead and try and max this. Let's see. It failed the first one. Oh my gosh. It applied the second one though. Okay, we got archaeologist. I think we'll get archaeologist out of those three. There we go. Perfect. Another archaeologist we'll get. And then the last one, please give me XP finder or something better at least. XP finder, we'll take it because I believe these go up to 7. So we'll try and get that going. They're selling even more XP, so I can just keep trying to apply these. Please work. Okay, we have to get a little bit more XP. Okay, so we should have enough. If this doesn't apply, it doesn't apply. It's only a 0.2% chance of it failing. Okay, it applied. So we have 2 max rebirthed enchants, XP finder and archaeologist. And then we're only missing 3 more books to max out the spawner finder and the value ticket finder combined. What is really good. So we got that situated. Wait a second. There's Tina the Tinkerer. I didn't even notice this. So wait, we can tinker books now, put in all books, get XP back. No way. I'm definitely doing this. Like, that is honestly one of the best features they just added. I didn't even know they added this. So I think we'll just tinker all this and then we'll try and apply the crop crusher. Okay, so we can buy at least one. Okay, bought one. If we're like slightly off, I'll just grind the XP. So let's take a look. Let's see how much it is to apply this. Oh my, it's super pricey. Okay, we'll just buy it. At this point, I just want to go ahead and apply it, see if it works. There we go. Even though we're not using crop crusher currently, we might as well apply it. So this is the hoe we have, the harvester hoe that is currently almost maxed. It's probably like halfway in rebirth stuff, but pretty much maxed in most of the non-rebirth things. So that is really good. We have a harvester hoe that is really worth a lot. So now, since I have the nether warp farm finished, I am going to go ahead and actually start using it. And then we're going to go ahead and build a sugarcane farm once I am done using this. So I'm going to give you guys an update once I'm done farming the nether wart. Okay, so after a while of grinding, I did actually manage to get nether wart done. If we take a look in Island Mastery, we are completely done on nether wart tier 1 or level 1. So now we can actually build the sugarcane farm. I do want to go ahead and spend my gems also. I've got 200,000 and we're going to upgrade one of our robots to max, one of the grinding ones. So then of course we can start making more gems and whatnot and XP. So we also have 13 more books we need to go ahead and open. So we're going to speed roll these and try and get something that we need. need, and if we don't, then we'll go to the tinkerer, is at least the plan I'm going for. We got a crop crusher, we'll sell. And by the way, all the crop crusher I did put on AH actually sold for 5 million each book. So if we take a look on AH, I have none up there, and also the needs PayPal sold, because it is the next day and everything sold while I was offline. We got a value ticket finder. What is the last one we need? So we do need some XP for that, and it's a 93% success. Let's open this last book really quick, and then we'll go ahead tinker all the ones we don't need. Okay, let's put all the books in. I put the other ones away, and we're gonna go ahead and sell, and we're gonna do money, and we're gonna do, I think we'll do 7.5 million for this book, and we need to do age search XP, 22 million. I'll cop that, and then can we apply this? Yes, we can, and it applied. So we're done with the default levels. We just need two rebirth. What we probably won't get done today, that'll be down the line, of course, or down the road. So now we need to build a sugarcane farm, what's going to be above this nether wart farm. And from what I recall, sugarcane does not need any light, so we're solved with that. We don't need any glowstone. So let's grab some dirt, and we're going to go up a decent bit here. So four blocks, and then we're just going to make a barricade around the whole thing really quick. Let's turn on chunks, and let's go ahead and make the barricade first. It took not too long, since we have this giant nether wart farm, to even get the whole thing done that I wanted to get done, the mastery. So that was pretty easy. I did buy some nether wart satchels, what just hold nether wart. I bought them because my inventory was filling way too quick, so I upgraded them with a bit of gems. We got 3 level 5s. You don't want to go past level 5 if you want to make your gems spent into them worthwhile. You just buy more satchels, is from what I've realized, and most players have realized at this point. Okay, so we have the level of where the sugarcane will be landing on, and then we need to figure out how we're gonna do the layout, and I gotta make sure I do it right the first time. So water on the outside, so that would be a block down, then we have the sugarcane on top of this, and then a block down, and then we repeat. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do this pattern for a while, and then copy it on the other side, so then it's lined up perfectly. Once we get close to the center here, what is gonna be in one more, so there we go. We'll go ahead and do the other side. I just have to go to spawn and reload the chunk. We're basically doing the same thing we did with the melon farm, just with sugarcane, and a little bit more compact, because sugarcane doesn't have like a full-on seed that grows a melon beside it like melons actually do. So it's kind of easier that we're doing sugarcane, and supposedly sugarcane is the most easiest crop to be using when trying to upgrade your skill in farming, so I'll probably be using that down the road. So if I'm correct, this is perfectly lined up with the whole island center. Let's just go ahead and double check. So I'm gonna line up here and then drop down. So I need to line up, and then we're gonna drop down here. Yeah, it's perfectly lined up. So we have the sugarcane farm layout finished. We just have to fill in all the dirt, put the water, put the sugarcane, and then we're good to go. I'm pretty sure nether wart doesn't need light, but if it does, I'll probably have to put some. What isn't an issue, but I'm pretty sure it does not need light. Also, people have been telling me fast place has been fixed actually, so we're gonna test this. Does it work? Oh my gosh, they fixed it. Okay, so we can use fast place now, so I can actually speed up this process by a ton. It was previously very funky, the fast place command, but now it actually works like flawless. The only downside is it doesn't take from your inventory. You have to keep switching slots, so every 5 times I place, I do need to go ahead and put more blocks in my hotbar. What is not really an issue, but it does speed up the process having this all situated with fast place. So I guess I can just turn off chunks because we won't be needing that. But anyways, I'm gonna get the dirt done, so let me go ahead and do that. Okay, so all the dirt is now done and placed, so we just need to go ahead and get all the water done. So we're gonna go to spawn to reload the chunks. We're gonna go into slash shop and buy about, I'd say, 5 stacks of buckets for now, and we'll buy more if we need them over time. So we got one row done. It only took a little bit of water, like it didn't take too much, and I'm trying to make sure every single one is a source, just because I prefer it to be that way. But it shouldn't take too long to do this. It's just the sugarcane itself is gonna be kind of tedious, so I'm just gonna place down the water, and then I'll also do the sugarcane, and I'll come back when the farm is completely done. So give me a moment here. So I just managed to actually finish making the sugarcane farm. Everything is completely done now. There we go, we've upgraded our harvester hoe, we made the sugarcane farm. A lot of progress has been made. By the way, check out how I had my best start in Minecraft Skyblock on screen.